On this episode, I'm going to show you how to make a charcuterie board and a cheese board, coming up next. Hey, it's Elizabeth with Amaze Apartment Homes in the beautiful Noda District in Charlotte, North Carolina. If you'd like a virtual tour of Amaze Apartment Homes, click in the description link below. Let's dive in how to make the best cheese board and charcuterie board. If you find this video helpful, click like, click subscribe, and I'm gonna show you all my tricks and all of the techniques. First, what you're gonna do is start off with, I like to either use a wood board or parchment paper to put down over a big baking sheet and start off first with the produce. Get your produce going, chop up some strawberries, chop up some raspberries, chop up some grapes. Have your produce ready first. I find that that's the easiest thing because it's usually more bulky. Some celery, some carrots, some cucumbers. Go through your kitchen. I bet you have a bunch of things in there that you can use for produce on your charcuterie board to help you build it out. I'll link down below how you can get your Ketonia bread mix. So next, I'm gonna go ahead and start with all the cheeses. I highly recommend Costco, of all places, has some really great cheeses to get, but you can get them Trader Joe's, Whole Foods, wherever you want. This is a blue cheese I'm pulling out. I had also broken the pieces in half. I do like to make the cheese somewhat symmetrical on the other sides of the cheese board, so a little bit of brie. I do cut up the brie, so then that way when people are eating with it, it's already pre-cut for them, as opposed to start them off having a couple pieces cut. I added some salami on there, some nitrate-free salami. I did chop up some more tomatoes with some mozzarella. Oh my goodness, just pairing those two together with some fresh basil out of my garden, absolutely amazing. I did have some chopped provolone. I actually found that in my refrigerator. I was not intending for those provolone cubes to be on there, but happened to go through my refrigerator and thought it would be great. There's the basil from my garden to add for the basil, tomato, and mozzarella, little sandwiches type things on there. I did also find some feta in my refrigerator. Again, I'm breaking it up into little pieces so that guests can easily eat off the cheese board, easily eat off the charcuterie board into little bite-sized finger type foods. I find that it invites people to actually eat more. I want them to eat my cheese board. I want them to eat my charcuterie board by having bite-sized manageable pieces on it. So make sure you're chopping. Make sure that you're making it manageable for your guests and your party guests to be able to consume the food that you do have on your cheese board and your charcuterie board. Next, I have all of these ramekins filled with different nuts. So I have pistachios, walnuts, cashews, sunflower seeds. Get little itty-bitty ramekins or sauce containers and put them on there. I ran out of ramekins, so I put the almonds that I did have just straight onto the parchment paper. There are some crackers. I prefer the Ketonia rolls instead, the garlic knot rolls instead, but you can put out crackers if you do have guests, maybe like the stone wheat type crackers to go with their cheese. Again, I do prefer the Ketonia bread because the garlic knots taste so much better than that. It's personal taste preference. I think it just tastes so much better. Here is the Kerrygold grass-fed cheese. Again, breaking it up into bite-sized pieces as opposed to a huge block of cheese where people don't have to chop and cut, that you can literally just make it manageable for them to be invited to eat your cheese board and charcuterie board. Again, adding more vegetables. I do have a dip coming up, a vegetable dip, but I did put down some yellow peppers I had chopped up. I also had an extra peach in there. I'm like, let's put that on there too. Get rid of some of the things out of my refrigerator. Again, more colors. I do like adding bright colors, yellows, reds, greens to my charcuterie and cheese board to add more vibrant colors, as opposed to just, you can see there with the cheese and the nuts, it's a white, it's a tan. This adds a little POC, some pop of color in there. And I'm trying to make it balanced out with the colors, with the apples added on there, your cucumbers. Be mindful, apples of course do brown, so be mindful of that they're gonna brown, so do it one of the last steps. I had some extra microgreens, some extra rosemary from my garden, some extra thyme, and I was using those as garnishes to put on there. So make sure you're adding some little garnishes, some greenery. If you don't have microgreens, great, put a little basil leaves, put a little spinach, put a little, just pop a color. I did have here also, I made a vegetable dip out of sour cream, and then I simply just added fresh Jack's Brunch Life seasoning to it to make a delicious dip to go with the vegetables, and to make it super, super tasty, of where people could, you know, want something with their vegetables, they can have a dip with it. And you simply just mix that Brunch Life dip around. It is absolutely delicious. And then I put a little garnish in there of some microgreens that I did have extra to add a little pop of color too. I try to work in triangle format, so you can see that the apples match with the strawberries, match with the tomatoes to make triangle of reds and triangle of yellows. You can see the colors. I try to make them in a triangle format too to help balance out the colors. But delicious cucumbers, because those can be dipped, or if you have people who are doing low carb keto, can put them on there. You'll see there the Cotonia coconut macaroons are absolutely amazing. Super, super helpful. You could even make this for a healthy dinner or for a healthy lunch. We frequently do a charcuterie board and cheese board, gosh, every other week for dinner, just because it's easy to put leftovers. It's kind of grab and pick. It's very filling because of the high fats and high proteins. Again, there's the coconut macaroons by Cotonia, handmade by a French pastry chef. They're so delicious. 16 come in a pack. They're absolutely amazing with the peaches in there, with the walnuts. There's some brie cheese that's already cut and sliced up. Again, make your items on your cheese board and on your charcuterie board bite-sized manageable pieces. Put a little spoon also with your dip too, with some side plates to encourage your guests to be able to make themselves a little appetizer or tapas plate. There's the spoon with it too. Ideally, you'd have more of an elegant spoon than a plastic spoon, but that's okay. And then there's those Cotonia coconut macaroons. My friends, I ended up putting extras because I ate them. Truth be told, I ate them because they're so good. If you love coconut macaroons, those are absolutely my favorites. Did add on there some fresh grapes as well for the color, but also for the flavors to go well with the cheeses, with the brie cheese, blue cheese, provolone, grass-fed cheddar, goat cheese. I found some extra goat cheese in there that I wanted to add a couple of crumbles for it as well. Cashews, walnuts, pecans, sunflower seeds, celery, green pepper, red pepper, cucumbers. There's so many different things, apples, peaches. There's so many different items that you can put on your cheese board. And I want you to think out of the box. I bet you have in your refrigerator right now a ton of leftover items to help enhance. But it's also with the height of your charcuterie board and cheese board, making sure with your ramekins, it makes it for higher spaces and then also lower spaces too. But the different levels on your cheese board and charcuterie board makes it more aesthetically pleasing. If you found this video helpful, smash that like button and click subscribe, and make sure you put a bunch of fresh produce as well into your cheese board and charcuterie board.